Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, what has happened to you? So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the bread came into them, and they lived, and stood upon their feet, an exceeding great army. Then said he unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say our bones are dried, and our hope is lost. We are cut off for our parts. Therefore prophesy unto them, Thus saith the Lord, Behold, my people, I will open your graves, and cause you to come up out of your graves, and bring you into the land of Israel. Ezekiel 37, 10 through 12. There have probably been times when people have asked you this question. What has happened to you? There have been times when you have been asked by someone else this question. What has happened to you? Maybe when somebody has gotten a haircut. Maybe when somebody has lost a bunch of weight. Or if you're not careful what you say, maybe it's when somebody has gained a bunch of weight. What has happened to you? We say that whenever something has changed about somebody, we see them, but there's something different than the last time we saw them. Do you know that when somebody gets born again, they ought to inspire this question in somebody's mind? When you come up out of that water, you should not be the same. You shouldn't act the same. You shouldn't have the same thoughts. If something really happened, you should be changed. And people ought to say, what has happened to you? Now I want us to take a look back at Ezekiel chapter 37, and one must wonder if the Lord probably took him to one of those churches where you can hear a pin drop even right in the middle of the sermon. The people are so dead that the message and the music don't excite them. The testimonies don't excite them. The words of encouragement don't encourage them. And they sure don't care anything about the word, so the preaching of the gospel don't get them going. I ain't trying to really hurt nobody, but the truth is, they are as lively as a bunch of dead dry bones. Don't ever let someone say that kind of stuff about your church. If they don't understand why you're so happy, just give them a while. They'll catch on. Let them leave saying, those people were wild. They sure do worship different. But do your church a big favor. Don't ever let somebody leave saying, my goodness, what a dead, dry group that was. There are plenty of those to pick from. God's not looking for any more bench warmers. God's not looking for any more part-timers. God's not looking for any more analyzers. God's not looking for any more doubters. God is looking for somebody that comes in expecting and leave rejoicing. God is looking for somebody that comes in hoping and leaves shouting. God is looking for somebody that comes in believing and leaves rejoicing. God don't need any more dead dry saints filling up in these dead dry churches. God needs somebody that has an experience that changed them, and they know what has happened to them. Somebody listening right now ought to be praising God. Don't you remember that over 2,000 years ago there was a God that loved you even before you were born? Loved you so much that he came down robed in human flesh, emptied himself of his glory, then was mocked, ridiculed, beaten, ultimately nailed to a cross. Don't you remember what it was like when you were baptized in his name? Don't you remember what it was like when you were filled with the Holy Ghost? You were bound, but now you're free. You were trapped, but now you're loose. You were going to hell, but now you're going into paradise. Don't you remember? What has happened to you? The thought of the day. God is looking for somebody that comes in expecting and leave rejoicing. God is looking for somebody that comes in hoping and leaves shouting. God is looking for somebody that comes in believing and leaves rejoicing. God bless you today. In Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.